See, we'll continue. We can consider efficiency of your auto engine. Efficiency of the auto engine. So there is two steps where we can exchange of the heat. That is Q1 and Q2 is an amount of heat absorbed and rejected during the isochoric process both time. So we consider Q1 is the amount of heat absorbed during the BC. So temperature changes from TB to the T. So we will get here M into CV TC minus TB. Amount of heat absorbed by the substance is this. CV is the specific heat at constant volume. So we can consider here, and Q2 is an amount of heat rejected is same as like the your CV. Here the change is from here TD to the TA. So you can be write the TA minus TD. So we get TD minus T. Once we get these two equations, equation number 1, suppose equation number 2, then we can be write the efficiency equation. Efficiency of your auto engine is 1 minus Q2 upon Q1. We can be write 1 minus M into CV TD minus TA divided by M into CV TC minus TB. TC minus TB. So absolutely M and CV is cancelled. So remaining term is here 1 minus TD minus TA divided by TC minus TB. So we got this. Now our aim is it should be replaced at least once. So we can use once again two curves which is cannot be considered now. That is anyone. See here point A and B. This is an your curve A, B, C and D. A and B, it is lies on the same adiabatic curve. It is lies on the same adiabatic curve. A and B is lies on same adiabatic curve. So there is a relation between the temperature and volume for the these two points is TA CA raised to gamma minus 1 is equal to TB CB raised to gamma minus 1. Now gamma is the ratio of the two specific heat CP divided by TB. Again we consider C and D. So your point C and D also lies on the same adiabatic. Point C and D lies on the same adiabatic. So we get TC, CC raised to gamma minus 1 is equal to TD, CD raised to gamma minus 1. See here, we can use the adiabatic relation here. A and B lies on the same adiabatic curve. So you can use the relation between temperature and volume. C and D lies on the same adiabatic curve. You can use the adiabatic relation. Now if you have to observe this, we have already discussed this, CA is equal to CD and VB is equal to CC. So we got this equation. I can represent as like this. TD, CD is replaced by the GA raised to gamma minus 1 is equal to TC. CC is replaced by CD raised to gamma minus 1. So we got this equation. Here, TD VA, TC VP. Using these two equations. CB is equal to CC and VA is equal to CA is equal to VC. Okay? So, we can use this equation and this equation. Suppose equation number 3, equation number 4. Now subtract the equation, this from this equation, that is subtract equation 3, subtract equation 3 from 4. Okay? So we got TD CA raised to gamma minus 1 minus TA CA raised to gamma minus 1 is equal to TC CB raised to gamma minus 1 minus TB CB raised to gamma minus 1. Now, VA raised to gamma minus 1 is common. So, you take outside. So, you got the TD minus TA into CA raised to gamma minus 1. TC minus TB. CB raised to gamma minus 1. So, in our equation for efficiency is this. TD minus TA divided by TC minus TB. So, we can manipulate this equation as like this, TD minus TA, this is your TA, divided by TC minus TB is equal to TD minus TA divided by TC minus TB. So, we got CB. Here CB raised to gamma minus 1 divided by CA raised to gamma minus 1. So, you can use this, you can put this equation number suppose 5 in your the efficiency equation. That efficiency equation is 1 minus TD minus TA divided by TC minus TB is equal to 1 minus CB raised to gamma minus 1 divided by CA raised to gamma minus 1. And this is equal to 1 minus 1 upon rho C raised to gamma minus 1. Now here rho C is equal to CA upon VB. Now see here CA VB is nothing but your the ratio of the your volume, that is the adiabatic compression CA to the VB. Volume is a VA to the VB. So it is called as a compression ratio. So this is our last equation, efficiency of your auto engine. Eta is equal to 1 minus 1 upon rho C raised to gamma minus 1. So, efficiency of auto engine depends upon your the compression ratio of your working substance. Compression ratio of the, now this efficiency must be equal to 1 it is an always less than the unity. It is not equal to the one. Means it is always less than the 100%. Why? Because of this factor. This factor you should be the subtract from this. Then we get the efficiency. That's why it is less than 1. So for if you want to increase the efficiency, efficiency will be the increases if rho c, that is the compression ratio, must be increased. Compression ratio must be increased. But if the compression is a ratio increases, your temperature is increased. Adiabatic process there, so temperature will be increased. So temperature is increases, then what happens? So it will try, but there is some limitation. If you increase the certain hand, the compression ratio, the temperature will be greater, there is an explosion of your the system. So there is a limitations to increase the your compression ratio. So there is a limitation for the increase the efficiency of your auto engine. So this is about your the auto engine efficiency. You should be remember it. Thank you.